this signal about the way that NASA now does business?
Well, thank you for having me on your show. First off, this is huge news if Intuitive Machines can stick this landing today. This is a big news for commercial space. This is big news for the United States. We haven't been to the surface of the moon since 1972. But this also is big news for NASA because it does validate the approach that they've taken for landing on the moon, of using commercial services to do that, which is very different than prior ways that NASA has done space missions.
And what's interesting is it creates opportunities for this particular company, who's seen its ultimate market valuation skyrocket on the back of this potential success, but also other startups. What sort of life has it breathed into the ecosystem here in the U.S.?
Yeah, so this one program that NASA has, which I'm thinking looks a lot like FedEx or Uber to the moon, where NASA is saying, we have a payload, we have something we want to get to the moon's surface, and we're paying for a company to take it there. There are 14 companies on that contract. They're from all around the country. Intuitive Machines is from Texas. Astrobotic, who attempted the first commercial landing under this program, they're from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. So the idea is that you have a lot of innovation, a lot of disruption in how you can do space. And the goal there is to create competition and then ultimately make it cheaper, to make it more cost effective to get something from Earth to the moon.
I mean, we understand that the Nova C, it's got 6 payloads from NASA, 5 commercial ones as well. And its contract is roughly about $100 million. It has escalated since when it was first signed on. Just talk us through how difficult it might be to stick this landing, like what failures we've seen relatively recently and what's going to be so important about this particular one.
Yeah, I think we sometimes forget how difficult it is just to get into space. So if we think about that in the context here, they had to get into space. They had to get from Earth to the moon. They had to orbit the moon. And that last step, landing on the moon, is probably the hardest part. We're having to relearn how to do that since we haven't done it for such a long time. The 3 prior commercial attempts to land on the moon didn't succeed. I think the one way to look at these missions is how maybe the tech sector works and how you can fail fast and learn a lot from those activities. Admittedly, this is my first TV interview. I'm sure I'm going to watch this later and think I could
never have
done something. I could have done something better, but I'll take that for the next one. And I think sometimes you only learn through doing and through trying.
Take us forward, therefore, Clayton. Say they stick the landing. It all works. What do we see evolve from there? What are the next key landmarks that we want, and space marks that we want to see coming from such companies and indeed NASA?
Yeah. One thing to keep in mind, so this is a commercial approach to doing space, to getting to the moon, but it's still payrolled bankrolled by the government. So this is NASA money funding these missions. So it's helping to learn how to get to the moon, using methodologies to get to the moon, investigating new technologies. But still, it's government money. So what I think we're really going to want to see is how these foundational capabilities and ways to do business in space, how then those carry over into other economic development in space, and how people learn to find business uses in space that aren't necessarily based on government money. That could be anything from asteroid mining to generating electricity to some kind of manufacturing. So we're on the cusp of that, and these programs are really helping to pave the way so that we know how to do that when that time comes.